Hello and welcome. My name is Alia Khan and you're watching The Modest Chapter. Today I have my friend Bilal Hassan with me. How are you?
I'm good. I'm alaikum salam.
So you're an icon. You're famous.
I don't know about that.
I'm so lucky to be sitting here. MashaAllah, you've got a great show called Being Bilal.
That's right.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And how's it going?
Yeah, it's great. It's been maybe 4 months of filming now. So
we've so what's the premise? What's the point of Being Bilal?
So this is essentially a reality TV show. Wasn't my idea, but I trained as a medical doctor and retired about a year ago to focus on community work, charity work, and just working across the British Muslim community and beyond. And I would do a lot of programs and events, and my cameraman who would film all of my events, he was more interested in telling the offline story. So after the event, going out with the teacher, with the sheikh, with the artist, with the, you know, whatever VIP is flown in, like those conversations in the coffee shops, in the car, and then my reflections, he was like, well, this is what people need to hear.
So what's the most fun and glamorous thing that you do? Being that we're in fashion and design, tell us what relevant story or pieces that
yeah,
you
Yeah, so there's lots of different creative stuff. So I partner on a record company, so sometimes I'm in a record studio and helping.
Doing what?
Just like, I don't know nothing about music, but it's just, I'm just like just listening to the vibes and like, yeah, maybe more strings there and less bass there. But that's fun. And then the next day, I mean, I do a whole bunch of stuff because my activism grew out of like alongside a medical career. So I used to just do lots of different things here and there as and when I could fit it in. And then as they've all sort of just grown, I've got my fingers in lots of pies. So one day I'm, you know, teaching at the University of Cambridge, and the next day, like, I just drove from the UK to Greece, you know, through 11 countries across Europe, and, you know, we just filmed this epic road trip, you know, across Europe.
Covering what? That's amazing. What were you doing?
So yeah, so we were actually going on an aid refugee. So, you know, the refugee crisis across Europe is really terrible, and in Greece in particular, it's really acute. And so we were taking aid, you know, donated items, food, clothes, etc.
Sanitary items.
To Greece. But then it was also like, instead of just telling that story, so you can tell a story in lots of different ways, and you can tell a story like, you know, this is the crisis, this is a refugee crisis, this is what they need. But it was like, with Being Bilal, it's telling the story through my eyes.
So how is that different from telling the story through
when I was up in Cambridge, I'm delivering this program, and you could have filmed the program, and it's great, I'm giving a workshop about team dynamics and leadership, but then what you didn't see is that, you know, half an hour before, I'm in my car on Google, like, planning, because I didn't prep much, right? So it's like seeing the backside of the story, which is more human, and it's more relatable. And the thing is, especially as Muslims, and Muslims in the West, our story is written about us and written, told to us, but not by us. And I think that's the difference. This is Muslims telling our story. It's not, I don't represent anyone other than myself, but it's a genuine, authentic narrative told by us, but for everyone.
So on this journey to help the Syrian refugees, tell us something interesting or unique that was from your perspective that you shared.
Yeah, so I mean, again, so I have like the medical perspective, I have a young person perspective, I have the perspective of, you know, someone, a friend of mine gave me, like, she had her, like, her most prized shawl, right? And instead of just, she's like, you know, Bilal, this is my most prized shawl, and, you know, I love this shawl, and can you give it to someone who, you know, who would really value it? So then this is like the story of the shawl. So, like, you know, I've got the shawl, and then I'm carrying the shawl, and it's in my suitcase, and then I go out, and I'm meeting someone, and I find a young, you know, girl who's lost her parents, and I'm like, oh, this is for you, it's from my friend.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, so it's cute, and it's real, and it's genuine.
How did she receive the shawl?
Yeah, she was very, very grateful, and, you know, it's really... when you're out there, and I've been in the aid field, you know, for a while, and it's really tough, you know, when you're looking face to face with people who, and we have to see. And I was always told that, you know, they said that the hand on top is better than the hand underneath, right? Yeah. The hand that you know, and people take that as the hand that gives, and they say therefore, like our teachers told us that when you give, you should give with your hands underneath and let them take, because in reality they're better than you because they're helping you fulfill a duty of giving.
So
it's very easy. Yeah, it's very easy to get those lines mishmashed. In reality, that, you know, we think we're helping them, but they're helping us, and they're teaching us what it means to be human.
Where can we catch your show?
So you can watch Being Bilal on, if you're in the UK or you have access to the Sky network, it's Sky 845, Sky Channel 845, and we have new episodes every Monday, Thursday, at 7 o'clock, but probably by the time this goes out, it'll be at 10 o'clock, 10 p.m. We're British Muslim TV, so you can watch it on. We stream online, www.britishmuslim.tv, and you can watch all our shows. There's a live stream there as well. So, if you're on Sky, Sky 845, or if you're online, BritishMuslim.tv.
What else can we catch on British Muslim TV? Do you guys have anything interesting for?
Loads of interesting stuff. Yeah. So from a
style and fashion perspective.
Yeah. So we have. The channel is education, lifestyle, and entertainment.
Okay.
So we have. The Sisters Hour show is really brilliant. The two girls, Nadia and Sakina. There's this one episode where I just go on a massive feminist rant, right? And looking at all the issues in the Muslim community with women and blah blah blah, and then I meet a friend and I'm just like incredibly misogynistic. And but that's just me, it's real, you know.
You just basically like to confuse people with your behavior versus your actual way of thinking.
Well, that's most people, isn't it? Most people are a mixed hodgepodge of things, and that's okay, you know, we're all misshapen.
That's
and
what makes life really interesting, yeah. And exciting.
And again, but when it comes back to narrative, like, the story of Muslims is told to us on the TV, on the media, on the news, in Hollywood, you know, so we were always written about, but like, let's have our own stories out there, and hopefully that can be cathartic and healing in many ways.
So tell us about the Sisters Hour.
So Sisters Hour is a magazine-style show. It's like an hour-long, 45-minute-long program, and they just do a whole bunch of different things. So they do a whole bunch of interesting fashion stuff, and they have creative soul sessions, or they do, like, they have spoken word poets and performers, and then they have, like, a spiritual element to it, and they have, like, a food element to it, and so it's a whole host of things.
For us, beauty tips that you can
They have a beauty tips.
For the good looks, Bill.
Luxury eyelash serum and how to make it with coconut balm and I want to say beeswax and
you're
some
sure
other
stuff.
No,
it's
I'm
not
sure.
Just like one of your concoctions.
No. Okay. But check it out. It's called Zizou's Beauty Tips, and it's one of our presenters, and she makes all these homemade, like, beauty stuff, a foot scrub and face mask and hair thing, and all from, like, ingredients at home.
That's really exciting. So is there anything else that you want to share with us?
I don't know. I think that the best thing is just to be yourself, right? And I think we're so comfortable being consumers of fashion and not being producers of fashion. And so just, you know, I think, you know, being Bilal and the show, and for me, my whatever fashion style, just be yourself. Do whatever you want to do. You want to put a dusty around your neck and put some glasses on it? It's okay. Go ahead. It's all
so
good.
So that is a prayer bead necklace.
This is a functional prayer bead that doubles up as a fashion accessory.
It's a new trend. Here we go.
There we go.
Being Bilal. Thank you so much for being on our show.
Pleasure.
And we'll see you next time.